featherweight champion of the world, now fighting in the lightweight division on a three-fight win streak, looking to make it four. In front of 20,000 fans, packed with celebrities and fight fans. What a night. A great stage for Banario to give us his best performance.
Jartim is a tall lightweight. We rarely see people out kind of, you know, height advantage on Banario, but Jartim is big. Banario's pressing Jartim up against the cage now. Again, I asked him, I was like, what do you want to showcase here tonight? What are you looking for in front of your crowd here in Manila? And he was like, I want another submission win. So he's calling his shot, saying he wants to take Jartim down and finish him on the floor. And that's kind of exactly what he's doing. Dropping down, changing levels. Jartim goes for the ride. Banario gets into side control.
He seems so much stronger at lightweight, Banario.
Oh yeah, this is one of the individuals that the weight cutting.
Yeah, really benefited, yeah.
Extreme, like we're seeing an entirely new Banario as he's not able, because he doesn't have to worry about the massive weight cut. And he walks around at 79 kilos.
He can concentrate on his conditioning at a comfortable weight, at a strong weight. And that's what we've seen from him in the last year or so.
Yeah, he says he has to diet down so he can't eat as much, but he has to lose a little bit of body fat to make the weight. Without the weight cutting, without the water restriction, he's a completely different athlete.
Just one of so many world champions in the arena tonight. Honorio Banario, the former featherweight title holder. Edward Falayan's coming up. Angela Lee's here. Brandon Vera's here. Rich Franklin's here. Manny Pacquiao's here.
Watch out.
Nice transition from Jartim. Banario tried to go knee on belly. He was thinking about, Jartim started to turn. He was thinking about taking the back, but Jartim was able to out kind of maneuver Banario and end up on top here.
Approaching the halfway mark, opening round. Banario takes a cuffing right hand and gets up and spins his man around and knees him to the hip. Sends it a right hand to the side of Jartim's body. Thump to the upper thigh.
It all counts.
They all do. Don't see many of those, though.
It all counts. A strike is a strike.
Action!
Sometimes you're with the shoulder, sometimes it's a punch to the thigh. And they do irritate you. You can set up something. So if you slap somebody on the thigh, you get them thinking about something else. And you can probably transition into something different.
Yeah, not happy that there's enough action going on. Throws them to the center of the cage, and they get straight into it.
Banario goes again for the takedown.
Whoa, took a big up kick from the sole of the foot there from Jartim. And it made a slapping sound.
And Jartim goes for a takedown of his own. Very well done. Slid right under the punch, got the double leg. Now puts Banario on his back. Banario able to stand back up, press Jartim up against the cage. He's got two underhooks now. So he's gonna be able to get a little bit better body control. He's got that head pressed up against the cage there.
Back into the center of the cage, Honorio Banario, and then gets pushed back across the cage. Hand around Bonario's leg, and you can see the height difference.
See, this clinch fighting is such a strategic game. You know, you gotta make sure you get your head in the right position, that head pressing up against Jartim. See how he's got his head underneath the chin of Jartim? Opens up, keeps the head high so he can slide an elbow right in there. Brandon Vera liked that one quite a bit.
Just looking at them there, they really have made another slapping sound, didn't it? There it is, that forearm again.
That's exactly what he needs to do when he gets this cage position. Keep the head open, open him up, drop in these strikes.
First time we've seen Jaroslav Jartim, 24 years old. Spent a lot of time in Prague in the Czech Republic. That's where he learned his game. There's Manny Pacquiao in the locker room with Eugene Toquero and Victor Cui. Enjoying the atmosphere, I'm quite sure. Chan Rotana looking for a photo as well with the former world boxing champion.
Big round for Banario. Let's see if Brandon Vera has that one scored so far. Brandon?
So, you know, it seems like both of these guys are going, it's a battle of attrition right now, first round. Both guys are kind of steady at their pace. They're taking each other down, working on the reversals and getting back up. A lot of ground control from both fighters. Let's see what happens. Let them, have them open up on their feet next round.
Seconds out, please. Seconds out.
There's that forearm to the head of Jartim. Bonario's style has changed fairly significantly in recent times. We talked about the weight difference and how he is stronger, but Team Lakai as a whole have improved their grappling games, specifically their takedown defense.
But now you would almost think that Bonario was naturally a wrestler and a grappler. Big head kick there, just barely misses Bonario, slid underneath it. And again, he goes right in for the takedown. This is definitely something that we're not used to seeing. Bonario consistently shooting for takedowns and not throwing those heavy hands and kick strikes.
A lot of Filipinos who get into the fight game started off just messing around with something that I think they call bouton, which is a form of wrestling. And that is where Bonario started. Kevin Beling on as well, very much had that kind of a background before being schooled in Wushu and transforming their activities to a striking-based martial art.
Here he is in the half guard of Jartim. So he's gonna wanna try to pop that leg out. He's got the right leg inside the half guard of Jartim, so he's gonna wanna try to slide that knee out, pass into side control. Jartim's doing the right thing by turning onto his side so he's not lying flat onto his back. Good reversal by Jartim to end up on top.
It's a great effort from the Czech fighter.
Bonario just stands right back up. Jartim up against the cage.
That's the strength of Bonario. Oh, left hand! Knocks him flat on his back, and with one punch, Honorio Banario extends his winning streak to four. That was a blistering finish.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Jeff Andres, property president of City of Dreams Manila, and the City of Dream guest ring girls. And now, folks, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 1:31 in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Honorio Banario!
Well, that is going to go down, isn't it? We're only in April, but that got to go down as one of the finishes of the year.
Contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night here between Adrian Pang and Honorio Banario. Banario said, if my hands hit Pang, Pang goes down.
Just that in his last contest, he was able to drop Jartim with a big straight right hand.
A feeling out process at the moment. There's the first heavy salvo from Pang off the right hand.
Pang was right. That was a clean straight right.
Pang has been around for a long, long time. He's seen it all, the Australian veteran. And the There's a reason they call Banario the Rock, as he tags Pang with a rock of the left hand. Inside leg kick, nice step across from Banario.
Banario's keeping his hands nice and tight to his head. That's also going to open up his body. So look for Pang, who's typically a headhunter, to go to the body, maybe land some hooks to that left side of the body. There he is, going to the straight right down the middle of the body.
Good body shot from Pang, controlling center ring, forcing Banario to the outside. Banario resets, he gets back to center ring, and the Filipino goes high, and the crowd loves it.
Good, is that Lakai push kick, that side kick comes straight up the middle. It really can go anywhere, it can go to the legs, the body, or the head.
Look at the stance on both of these athletes. The flat-footed Adrian Pang. Up on the balls of his feet is Honorio Banario. Pang edging forward. Pang, will he pull the trigger on the left hook? And he does indeed.
Man, these guys are throwing some heavy hands, Michael. I don't expect this one to go full distance, but you never know with the Rock in the Australian bruiser Pang in there.
Banario looking for a takedown, couldn't affect it. Short right hook there from Pang, and Banario just ducked under in time. There's the left hand from the Rock.
He is going that left hook to the body again.
Trying to close down the movement of the Rock is the hunter, Adrian Pang.
Soft bullying. Really utilized a lot of lateral movement when he went up against Pang. He was able to move left and right and land in a lot of different unorthodox techniques. Banario doesn't have the same spinning techniques. He likes a more linear path. He likes to come straight up the middle with that 1-2 and also that push kick.
Pang following him around. Cutting side kick to the midsection there from Banario. There's the left hand from the Rock.
We've seen in the past that Pang can actually start to get frustrated with opponents that move a lot. So the more we see Banario on his bicycle moving laterally left and right, you're going to start to see Pang start to get a little bit frustrated.
Sometimes it takes a hard shot to the jaw to wake up Adrian Pang. And once he awakes, it's like stirring a sleeping dragon. Banario roundhouse kick, the crack reverberated around this massive arena. Uppercut to a left hook, and a left hook from Adrian Pang. Pang with the overhand right. Looks for a takedown to Banario, and Pang stuffs it.
Banario mixing things up a little bit. You can see Pang trying to cut the corner. So right as Banario tries to circle to the right or the left, Pang is right there cutting him off, trying to contain him in the corner. The hunter he truly is, stalking his prey.
Short hooks on the inside from Pang, and Banario drifts up to his right. Counterclockwise into the lead hand of Pang, which is where he wants to go.
Drift, keep going.
Don't want to drift left into the power side of the hunter, Adrian Pang. The Rock fires out the front kick.
As Banario throws a combination, there's a moment where Pang kind of drops his hands to like almost say, that was it, that's all you got. If Banario can time that correctly and come up with another immediate combo, he can catch Pang.
How many millions around the Philippines are watching live on ABS-CBN Sports in action right now, on the edge of their seats, cheering for the Rock and Mario Banario.
That's the frustration. That's
oh,
the frustration.
Smack bang, smack bang, smack bang, and again, and again, and once more, there's another one. The Rock on fire, the Rock on fire, and here comes Adrian Pang.
Careful what you ask for, Michael. Pang opened his hand, said, where you at? Let's do it, toe-to-toe, let's dance. And Banario chose to unload on Pang with big push kicks, combinations. Look at that, straight up the middle with the Lakai push kick, and then answers back, jab, body, hook. Brilliant combinations by the Rock. The Lakai push kick again. Beautifully done. Careful what you ask for, Hunter.
All right, Dre. coach, what are you telling the hunter to do?
He's got to be careful with the frustration of Bonario's movement. He has to stay patient, stay calm, consistently cut the corners. As Bonario starts to cut the corners, throw some hands, but also mix up the weapons. He's only throwing the hands.
Look at the sellout crowd inside the Mighty Mall of Asia Arena. Not even standing room. It's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship. Heroes of Honor, the largest martial arts organization in the world. Producing another stellar bout.
I want to see Pang throw leg kicks. I want to see him maybe attempt a takedown. All he's doing is stalking Bonario, coming forward and throwing hands. He's got to change it up, mix up the tactics so he starts to give Bonario something else to think about.
Mitch, what you're saying is you want to see the Pang and Bang.
Exactly. But I want to see it mixed in with other things, threaten the takedowns. He said he was going to win by submission. How's he going to do that if he just stands there and wants to punch him in the face?
Edging forward again is the hunter from Australia. Inside thigh kick from the right. Pang goes to the body, misses the target, takes a breather. He's getting frustrated here, Adrian Pang, because of the movement of Bonario. High kick from Bonario, goes for the headache maker. Pang goes to the body, Bonario a little too evasive, a little too slick. Punching combinations in close.
Forward, starts stepping to the left. So as Bonario starts to circle out, he's gonna cut him off. But then as he does that, he's going to the power side of Bonario. I like how he's parrying that push kick now. Now Pang's got that figured out, so as he's throwing the push kick, he's starting to parry it with the lead hand.
Pang resets again. He's having trouble closing down the movement of the rock Honorio Banario.
I want to see Pang start throwing leg kicks, start chopping Bonario down, slow down that footwork. Oh, you heard that.
My word. I heard that in the nosebleeds. Inside thigh kick from Bonario. Pang comes forward again. Bonario's been slick. He's been elusive all contest thus far. Inside leg kick to that femoral profunda. Outside leg kick to the common peroneal nerve. And again from the hunter. There's the right hand, and the rock comes over with the left.
There's the leg kicks. That's what I want to see from Pang. See, now he's circling through the corner, but Bonario spins right around. Circles right out.
This may not be a one super series bout, but the striking is awesome all the same. And you feel that Pang's lifting the intensity. He's hyping the aggressive meter. Goes to the body, goes to the head. He tagged the rock with the right hand.
That's where he's so effective. When he gets in there, gets close, starts attacking the body and throwing those hooks to the head. You can just hear the thundering hands of the Australian bouncing off of Bonario's head.
Pang's confidence is building with 2 minutes 15 remaining in the second round. They clinch up against the ropes. Knee there from Bonario. The Filipino. Another knee to the right side of the body of the hunter. Elbow from Bonario. Thought about a spinning elbow, did Pang. And Bonario back on his bike using this large ring. And Pang get that momentum flowing again. It's coming spurts for the Australian. Look how much of the ring the rock. Oh, he tagged it! The sweat flew off the brow of Bonario. There's a gap punching knee from Pang. And the rock circles off. He felt the power. He felt the Pang and Bang! There's the high kick from the rock.
That's where Pang is most effective, when he can stop the movement of Bonario and start to go to work. See how Bonario's covering up like that? I'd like to see Pang throw an uppercut right up the middle and lift Bonario up out of the ropes.
Pang's confidence is oozing, but how's his gas tank faring? You know, the gas tank won't fail on Bonario, it never does on Team Lakai. But this has been a great round for Adrian Pang. Can he close it down? Can he cut him off and go the Pang and Bang?
There's the leg kicks. Pang's got to go back for those leg kicks. Stop the movement again, yes! Attack the legs, but Bonario can't cover up like that. Can't just cower, he's gotta move.
We saw Bonario go kleptomaniac towards the end of the first round, toe-to-toe. Will it do it again here? Will we see the Lakai side kicks?
Pang so bad to put on a show. He wants to go toe-to-toe. He wants to do that dance in a phone booth. But he's got to be careful. He's got to keep his hands up, chin protected, wait down on that mouthpiece and go to battle.
Beautiful little left hand in there from The Rock. Sticks out the jab as Benaria on his back again. And Pang says, come on, let's go toe-to-toe and duke it out. But Benario's not going to fall for that. Oh, Pang catches him with the left hand.
Gets him again. Getting him over and over. The minute Benario is able to stay stationary, Pang is, because he covers up, and then Pang just has target practice. Boom, boom, boom. Look at that combination. Boom, good combination by both guys. Look, Benario stops movement. Bang, bang. And that's where Pang is able to exploit some of these combinations. It's when Benario stops, and that's when Pang can do some of his work. Good head movement there shown by Benario. Just barely missed with a head kick there. Now we're starting to see Pang turn it on. That constant movement from Benario didn't really let him show that frustration on his face, but Benario's slowing down a little bit. He's not as explosive in his footwork. That stalking by Pang is starting to slow down Benario.
The Rock, Honorio Banario. The Hunter, Adrian Pang. Australia versus the Philippines, third and final round. Will one of these men find a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night? In front of a sellout crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila of the Philippines. Will Pang get the brawl he so desperately wants?
Mario's got to keep moving. He's got a jab, move, come in and out with these strikes, throw that push kick down the middle again, just like that.
Pang. The crowd are absolutely eating up everything Benario's doing.
Pang just cannot be involved in a boring match.
Never. It's not his nature. Edges forward as the Aussie rides the leg kick. This one really has been a glorified kickboxing contest, even though it's not a one super serious battle.
He's got to be careful with that momentary lapse where he tries to, you know, egg on Benario. Benario was just right there. He was running. He caught him with a leg kick. It was a bit low.
Roundhouse kick from The Rock. Checks the low kick from Pang. Circles. Going counterclockwise. Drifting to his right.
Pang doesn't like it, but it's effective. Benario can keep moving, throw strikes. That's going to be how he's going to outpoint Pang in this portion. But when he gets sucked into Pang's game and stands there and goes toe-to-toe, he loses a lot of the exchanges, Mike.
What Pang wants to do now is throw that left hand and try to get Benario to shift into his right hand. Trying to get Benario to circle the other way.
But you can see that Benario is the one circling to Pang's lead hand, so he's circling to the weak side, and Benario has to cut him off, and so he circles into Benario's power side.
Something that is key here, Mitch, the scoring of one championship global rules set relies a lot on aggression. Who's the aggressor in this contest?
By far, it's the Hunter, Adrian Pang. He's the one that's hunting down Benario, but that's only one of the categories of our scoring system. Striking superiority is a lot higher up in the categories, Michael. And do you think that Benario is showing striking superiority, at least here in the third round?
No, not at the moment, I don't. I think that it's Adrian Pang who's got the striking superiority at the moment, continually coming forward. But there have been better spurts of striking superiority through this contest from Honorio Banario. Pang edges forward. Benario just shaved the whiskers with that hook.
Man, there must be concrete in the head of Adrian Pang. He takes things on the chin, and he doesn't even move. How strong is his neck?
Pang frustrated by the eternal movement here of Benario, but it's a clever strategy from The Rock. Outside leg kick from Pang, something he should be doing a whole lot more.
Benario's got 5 knockout wins. He can put people to sleep, but Adrian Pang barely flinches when Benario catches him.
Pang's been landing some good leg kicks, and again, this is all scoring stuff for Adrian Pang.
Nice jab by Benario.
Body shot from The Rock. Pang continues to come forward. Benario continues to back up. How will that affect the judges and their scoring? Beautiful two-punch combination, the old 3-2. Uppercut from Pang, sticks him nicely, rocks the head back.
That's the uppercut, Michael. That's what I want to see. Bernardo's guard, when he's stationary, is perfectly timed for an uppercut.
Pang is winning the striking in this final round, Mitch.
I don't know if I give it. I might give him the striking advantage in the second round, too.
Body shots again from Adrian Pang. 1 minute 20 remaining. Some would say 80 seconds. Pang with a spinning back kick. He looked for the liver. Amazing from Adrian Pang.
There's some diversity. Adrian Pang is not just a one-trick pony with the punches. He can throw spinning heel kicks to the liver.
Adrian Pang on the front foot. The hunter is hunting the rock all around the ring. Bernardo's going to go down. Bernardo's going to start doing some more work.
He's got to let it go. He can't just keep jogging around like this. He's got to put forward the pressure. He has to put himself in danger, stand there, go toe-to-toe, because at the end of the first round, that's where he had the best exchange.
High right roundhouse kick from Pang. Pang has continually come forward. He takes those shots to the chest. Tries for a counter right hand. Bernardo goes for the high kick, but it didn't connect. As Pang straight back after him. Pang saying, come on, Rick. He's running from me. And here comes the hunter. Maybe the Pang and Bang in the final second. Bernardo's head's low. Can he throw the knee? Goes to the body, does Pang. There's the knee. There's the uppercut. Pang rubs the jab. This has been Pang's round, but we are scoring the bout in its entirety.
You don't judge round by round, so it's not 2-1, 1-2, 3-0. It is the entire thing. And I am so glad I just pretend to be a judge, because that was one of the most entertaining matches of the night. I don't know how to call it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the red corner. And judge number three scores this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner, Honorio Banario!
It couldn't have been any closer. A split decision goes the way of the Rock, Honorio Banario. And they give a standing ovation here in Manila. Adrian Pang is absolutely gutted. And the Rock, Honorio Banario, sends a message to the lightweight division. In front of a sellout crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Honorio Banario in the familiar Tim McKay red trunks. And Rahul Raju of India in the black. First member of Team McKay. Here tonight, the power team in Asian martial arts, Team McKay.
Banario uses that side push kick so effectively. Likes to take it to the leg, the body, and the head.
Rahul Raju says he has the strategy. And can he implement the game plan tonight? Banario so hard to stop, particularly in front of a Filipino crowd. Roundhouse kick there from the Rock. Raju towers over the Filipino. And he used that length to his advantage. Rock would love to get on the inside and land those heavy salvos to the jaw. Fake there from Rahul.
Rahul keeping pressure on, backs him up against the cage. There's that clinch. Let's see if he can get it. Good defense so far by Banario. He's going to use those underhooks to pick him up.
Nice little knee on the inside there from Banario. Rahul Raju would love to put the Filipino on his back here. In the corner of Rahul Raju, a one championship star, Emilio Urrutia, barking instructions.
Mario looks relaxed up against the cage, utilizing the underhooks well, but he's also countering with those knees very effectively. He removes the arms from the midsection and he fires in those knees. Now look for Banario to change levels, drop down and attack that single leg. Yep, there he goes.
Watching the leg there from Honorio Banario. Gets the takedown on Rahul Raju.
And he traps that leg. Raju's still got one leg out, so he can still stand up. But he's got to get that leg out between Benario's legs. Look for Benario trying to scoot the hips away from the cage, turn his back off of the cage, and put his back onto the mat.
Raju glances towards his corner.
Maybe Raju heard me because he's got that post out. Now he's trying to work his way back up to his feet. Good job.
He gets through the big Indian, swings wildly with the left hand, goes back to center cage. Almost the halfway point of this open, set for three. Wushu's sidekick there from Honorio Banario, the inaugural champion at this weight, Honorio Banario. Nice stiff jab, smack bang, between the eyes of Raju. Good trajectory on the knee there from Banario.
Mario closes that distance incredibly fast. He likes that jab. He also likes that lead left hook.
Where does Raju go from here, Dragon?
Well, he's got Banario controlling that arm. He's got to stop punching the back of the head because that's not doing a lot. Yep, he's got to defend with that right arm. Now he's got to try to swim in knee underneath or just keep that wizard right there. See, he's trying to get underneath. He's trying to take that hand and get right by the left arm. There he is. But look at that. Banario was able to exit, create a little bit of space, punch, and then get back into that underhook.
A real tussle between these two in this opening round. Cat munching knee there from Honorio Banario. Body shot from Rahul Raju.
Banario does those knees so well. He finds those little tiny openings by removing Raju's arms from his midsection to fire in those knees, just like that. See how he has that arm trapped? Boom. Comes in.
Both men trading knees on the inside. There's a corking one to the thigh from Raju. Need the belly button from Honorio Banario. Fires up a horizontal elbow. There's another one trying to take the beard off the Indian.
I like how he swims in. As he's trying to swim, he's trying to get that underhook on the side, but instead, he's coming across with a beautifully timed elbow. He did it twice now.
The high left roundhouse kick. And again from Banario. Heavy salvos from The Rock in the opening round. Backs Rahul against the cage. What are the options for Rahul Raju now, Mitch?
Rahul Raju sees he's got an overhook on one side, so that's good, so he can keep Banario's posture up, and he can also knee. But what he needs to do is he needs to get Banario to let go of his wrist, so he needs to kind of get that hand, Banario's left hand, off of his, because Banario is able to strike with it. He pushes the hand down, waits for the frame, and comes back up over the top, just like that with the elbow again. Rahul's got to do something about Banario controlling that hand. He keeps controlling one hand while he has the underhook on the other, and then he's landing these strikes inside the clinch.
Oh, Rahul trying to get a head full of steam. Boxing combinations not working, though, for the Indian. And we go to the towers at the end of one. It's one championship conquest of champions. Live from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines.
Wow, Benario's hands were on point that round. Look at that jab, that stiff jab just snuck right in there. Came in right into the clinch. Watch, this is what he's doing. Look at the hand. The hand comes down, boom, he gets him thinking about it, comes over the top with the left hand. His clinch striking, that dirty boxing is so effective from Benario. He's controlling the hands, getting Raju to think about something. The corner has to address that clinch fighting.
Mark Sanjao in the corner of Honorio Banario. Emilia Urrutia in the corner of Rahul Raju. Second round of three of this catchweight contest at 79 kilos. India versus the Philippines. A magnificent sold-out crowd here in Manila. That's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship. Wushu's sidekick to the lead fight early there from Banario. Raju looking for a takedown in the early get-go here. And the Indian find it.
I like the change of strategy. He's not giving up on that single leg. Good job to turn the corner to put Banario on his back.
Tower jump up on the head.
Three Olivier Costa says, watch the blows to the back of the head. On his back here, Banario. Raju wants to keep him there with the ground and pound and half guard.
Mario's trying trying to scramble back up. He's got to be careful. Jartim might be able to sink in the back. He's a little bit high on the back right now. Bernardo's going to try to pull that arm off. He's going to try to posture up. He's got to get that arm to the other side of the head to defend the choke.
Mays here to the side of the head, and again from Rahul Rajur. The Indian having a much more impressive second round thus far. Side control position now. North south from Rahul Rajur. Bernardo back to his feet!
True Lakai style fashion was able to scramble out, boom, connect on her right hand, and then start to take control of that round. It was a very interesting second round, Michael Schiavello. Oh, we're gonna keep going with it. Look at Raju marching forward, attacking the legs, continually trying to press after the takedown. That was a great second round for both these guys, but I think that Banario has the advantage in almost every single category, Mr. Schiavello.
Emilio Rocha about to burst a blood vessel in the corner of Rahul Raju. A little more composed in Team Legai's corner for Honorio Banario. Third and final round. In front of a massive sea of fans for Banario here in Manila.
Ready? Ready?
Banario in the red, our mixed martial arts rules contest. After this, we've got our double main event. How about that? A jab, then a right hand to the body from Banario. Outside leg kick from the Filipino. Raju waiting for an opportunity. There it is. Gets a takedown. Reversal. No. To his feet, Banario takes the back standing. There's Raju.
Job for Raju to dive for the takedown. Caught the leg kick, went after the double leg. Banario scrambles back up. Raju didn't let go, kept hunting after it. Now he's got the body lock. He's gonna try to outside trip. Banario sneaking that arm inside. Now we're back to neutral, 50-50.
Hey there from Banario, planting the hook. Raju breaks off. Referee Olivia Cost calls for action. Dancing now, the Filipino resets himself. Looks for the inside lead leg. Both men fatigued here in the third. Driving double leg takedown attempt here from the Rocks. Spurs out, but he gets a takedown anyway. To his feet now, Raju. Let's see if there's some opportunity here for the Indian.
Just trying to go after that knee tap. He went for a double leg. Now he's transitioning into a high crotch. Bernario's pulling his head up. That's good. Get the. But Raju is aggressive with these takedowns, going after these legs, trying to wear on Banario. Banario's trying to attack into Kimura on the left side of Raju. Raju's got to be careful, postures up. He might take, be able to take the back.
Banario's. Banario would love a finish in front of this Filipino audience. Top position now for the Rock. Half down. What can he do from here?
Good scramble. Let's see if Raju can get a butterfly hook on the other side so he can elevate, create a little bit of space. Banario's now just laying on the top position. He's got to be active. Olivia Cost will pop these guys up. Now, look at, yeah, Raju was able to elevate, but Banario stuck around and took the back.
Banario has the back, and he's putting him out like an Indian pancake. 3 minutes, 35 remaining. And control, Honorio Banario.
Raju might be able to pop on the back. He does.
A little bit slippery, a lot of sweat. Here the hand from Banario. He tags it. High up and down. From Raju was nowhere near the target. 2-10 remains. Third and final round. Raju is spent here. He is gassed. Up and down again from the Rock.
This is a grueling pace, Michael. All that scrambling, all that clinching, it's going to wear on you. It's just going to suck your energy out, and that's what both these athletes are experiencing this. I've never seen Banario this tired in a third round.
Uppercut there again from the Indian. Both men are gasping. Looking for one big, tub-thumping shot that will change the complexion of this match. Goes for a takedown. Does Raju? Does he have it in him, though? 90 seconds now. Gut-munching knee, tries to fold him in half like origami.
Man,
tremendous heart and guts and intestinal fortitude by these two martial arts warriors.
The only word I'm thinking about is kleptomaniac, Michael Schiavello. Can Raju do it enough in these next 60 seconds to try to get the match? It's so close at this point. He's starting to come ahead. Banario actually looks like he's slowing down. Look at Raju securing a takedown, but Banario immediately starts to get active again.
An amazing performance on very short notice for Rahul Raju. Emilio Urrutia is losing the plot in Rogers' corner, screaming at him. High knees don't really connect. He breaks up the Indian. Now 35 seconds on the clock. Let's see if The Rock can rock and roll one more time. Benario taking it front to the eye, thinking heavily. Flush again. Raju forces him back against the wire.
He's got to change his level. He's a bit high there. He's too bent over to get this takedown. He's got to drive his hips underneath him and secure that takedown. Turn the corner. He's attacking that leg.
This would be amazing. This would be epic. He almost had it in the dying stages. This place goes bananas.
So close. He had the choke in, but the position wasn't correct. Raju was able to turn away as all of Team Lakai's world champions are chilling on Banario. In complete exhaustion, both these guys fall to the canvas.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the
back and forth battle, defeats Rahul Raju by decision.